our mental preparation, our physical preparation. And I know the last couple of days I've been kind of picking Annette's brain, and I've been learning a lot of new things. And I'm wondering if, Annette, you can share a few tips for us in that area.
So first of all, I want to point out that Jessica has mentioned every single feature of this gun that I'm really liking. And like, I don't get to talk about this. Really, the trigger for me, because my background includes competition, but I started in the concealed carry world, and that's where I spend most of my time now. And one of the things that I think about when I carry a gun for self-defense is, am I ready to actually use that against another human being? I want to be really, really sure that I am. And that's something I have to think about every time I put a gun on before I go out, because I don't want to decide or find out in the moment of an attack that I'm not actually ready to do that. So one of the things I'd encourage all of you to do is think really, really hard today, tonight, tomorrow, every time you put on a gun, am I ready to use this to defend myself? But the other thing I want you to think about, it's not just about, well, what am I going to do to this other person, is how much do I matter, right? One of my mentors, Kathy Jackson, once told me, you are worth defending. You, all by yourself, are worth defending. And it makes me tear up every time. So that's the other thing you need to think about every day, tonight, go home, every time you put on that gun. You are worth defending and worth doing what it takes to keep you alive, or worth doing whatever it takes for you to go out on your own terms.
Excellent. Thank you for that. And Beth, what can you add from the educational side for us?
I just love what both of these women have said, and it's echoing a lot of what the ladies have learned in our classes over the last couple days. We talked about aggressive grip, and I was like, you go ask someone. I'm terrible with microphones. Like, you go ask someone for an aggressive grip, and they're going, what does that mean? Well, let me tell you, I'm the mom with a gun here. That's all I am. I'm just a mom with a gun. If I don't have an aggressive grip and I've got applesauce and baby drool and all sorts of other crumbs and stupid crap on my hands because my kids are very sloppy, I need that aggressive grip. And in the heat of the moment under that stress, that's a huge benefit. That's one of my favorite things. And I haven't even seen this gun, touched this gun, or had any interaction with this gun, and I already like it just for that. So this mom with a gun is saying, you know, A+ for you. But also on the mental side of things, a lot of times I turn the question around on people when they're like, oh my gosh, how could you even carry a gun? That's so dangerous. And aren't you a terrible mom? What a terrible mom. You're a parent and you have guns? And I'm like, okay, not only are you worth defending, but look around you. Who are you with? Who are you with right now? Who are you with most often? And when it all boils down to it, for me, I've got three reasons. My oldest child, my middle child, my youngest child. Without me, who defends them? And without a firearm, where's the equality in the fight? And that's all that it is. It's that simple. You are all worth defending.